Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I've got another unboxing video for a FDM printer. And this one was provided by Elegoo and they sent me their Centauri Carbon printer. So let's check it out.
Yee!
Now before we get in, let me say that Elegoo did send me this printer and their filament for free, but I am not being paid to say anything nice and I am not under contract with them. So this is just gonna be all of my firsthand experiences and thoughts for this printer. And for unboxing the printer, it actually was pretty simple. The glass part was on top, covered by some of their foam cutouts, and then I just got that, put it to the side, and then the rest was literally the printer box. And that part I did have to have help just because I could not physically pull it out of the box on my own. So I got my spouse to help me and carry it over to my printer table. There also is still some more things that you will have to pull out, specifically from the top part, and one will be just a cardboard box, and this is gonna have all of your manuals and other parts that they provided with the printer, as well as there's still gonna be a bunch of foam elements inside of it, and make sure to get it all out. There was one that I almost missed that was stuck behind where the printer head rests, and it's just this tiny piece of foam, so make sure to grab that one. And inside the cardboard box, it did come with the touchscreen, the spool holder, a small filament sample, which was white PLA.
It came with a glue stick.
It also came with the specific Elegoo glue stick for your printer bed to help with the pieces stick better, as well as grease for the printer, your power cord, an unclogging pin tool, Allen wrenches, screwdrivers, a spare heat bed nozzle wiper, your USB drive, a scraper blade, as well as your user manual. And for me, I followed the instructions from the paper user manual, but I highly recommend scanning the QR code in that manual, which is going to take you to a much more detailed digital version, which I really wish I had used because the paper one did not quite go over everything in full detail that I would have liked, but it still got me by. And there aren't too many steps for setting up this printer to have it print, which was really cool. But you will have to unscrew three screws with your Allen wrenches to unlock your bed, as well as they're gonna have this cable that's sticking out of the front, and that is what you're going to be attaching your screen to. And then it will insert and fit into some holes on the front panel of your printer. And then on the right side of the printer, that handle-like piece is what your spool is going to attach to. So you're going to insert it and screw it on. And I'm going to be using the Elegoo provided spool of filament. It was a PLA one that they gave me, color gray. And for putting it on, you're going to put it on that handle-like piece, but unlike other printers, it's going to go counterclockwise and then insert into the hole on this little back piece, and then you're going to push it through the tube until it connects. And I will note, I did have later on with printing a little bit of issues with this part, but I'll get to that in a sec. But first, there was still a little bit more stuff on the inside, so I had to unlock the printer head that was wrapped up with zip ties and cardboard, then to turn it on and start setting it up. And at this point, you're pretty much going to follow the on-screen directions, choosing your language. For me, obviously it's English, but you can also have it for French, German, Russian, Italian, Spanish, Japanese, and Chinese. And then just making sure the build plate was inserted correctly, and it actually sticks by magnets. It is a PLA specific and textured PEI dual-sided plate. And I used the textured side and it worked fantastic for me. And I didn't even have to use the glue stick for any of my prints. Oh, and don't forget to put the top part of your printer on, because I kind of left that in the corner and the instructions never said to do that. Oopsie. But yeah, just remove the film on either side and put the glass lid on top. And this is what's going to make this printer a fully enclosed one. And I will note that this printer is actually made out of metal and glass. Then again, I followed the touchscreen with going over all of the extruding parts, making sure that my filament was actually coming through and I could start my first print, which of course is going to be the boat. And the files for mine were actually on the thumb drive and that was provided. And you're just going to insert it into the printer in the front, then select the boat image and print, and it will start.
And print.
And this sample print only took 15 minutes and was extremely fast. And the max printing speed for this printer is 500 millimeters per second, as well as the max acceleration was 20,000 millimeters a second squared. And one of the cool features about this printer is it also has a light on the inside. And it took me a little bit to realize that, but it's actually on the touchscreen. It's the green icon that looks like a light bulb that's lit up. Hey, yeah, do that. That'll make it a lot easier to see your print. As well as that same location where that light is actually the camera that is inside of your printer. And you can do time lapses of your prints. And the print was pretty well done. There wasn't too bad of stair stepping. I would still personally clean this up for my personal use, but it is really good for just a one-off print and it wouldn't need too much cleanup. And the thumb drive did also have other sample prints besides the boat on it, including the CC Mini, an Eiffel Tower, a scraper, a Buddha, and a vase. And the one that you will need to print out though is the CC Mini, because this one is actually going to be put onto the printer. Specifically onto the back, because this is where all of the extra pieces of filaments that the printer cuts off and extrudes are going to go into this box, and eventually it will fill up and you can toss it. As well as the next print you will want to do is the scraper. And it comes with the scraper holder, as well as a second mini part for the scraper. And in your bag, you will actually have two screws that perfectly fit for going into this piece, as well as your blade. And this you will, after it is printed, attach and you have your own scraper. And now that that's all out of the way, I can start printing my actual CAD files I've made. And I'll note that for this specific printer, you can use PLA, PETG, ABS, ASA, TPU, PET, PC, and PA filaments. But first, we're going to need a slicer program, and Elegoo has you covered. Just go straight to their website and click their software tab button, and it'll bring you up with three options. I'm actually using the one for their FDM printing, because we have an FDM printer, and it's the Elegoo slicer. They also have a resin one and a mobile app version, and the best part is it is free. And then you can just import your file. I use STLs, but it also takes OBJ, 3MF, and STP. And I found that it typically imports your files into millimeters, and my files that I work in are actually inches, so it does have a scaling, and just click the scale button, and because it has it at 100, just turn it into 2540, and this is the number that will scale it equally to the inch unit. As well as if you're importing one file with multiple pieces, typically this will just be as one piece to move around, but it does have the option where you can separate each of the pieces individually and have individual units, as well as if you need to move them in any directions, you can. If your object comes in at a weird angle and you want a specific piece to lay flat on the bed, you can click that and then click the part that you want to lay flat on the bed and it'll automatically put it to that angle. It also gives you complete control for customizing your wall loops, the thicknesses, what type of support structure you want, whether it's going to be the tree support or if you want your traditional line support, the strength of your piece, if you want your infill to be the honeycomb or if you want it to be rectangular, as well as how dense you want your infill to be. And when you're done and you're happy with all of that, just click on the top right slice plate and then it can automatically generate all of your support structures and it'll tell you how long each step will take to print and it's color coordinated, as well as the total print time. And then you can use the bar on the right to go down and see each individual process to see if you need to go back and add some support somewhere, add a different piece, and make sure that it is what you want to print. And another cool feature is it has Wi-Fi, so you don't have to use that USB drive if you do not want to. You still can, but it was really nice because my printer is actually in the basement and my shop is on the first floor. So I can do this all upstairs and I can just import it to my printer without even having to go downstairs. And what's even better is you don't even need to go downstairs to make sure that it starts printing. You just need to click the device tab at the top left, and that camera in your printer will show you live coverage of your print and everything. As it's heating up, it'll tell you how long it's going to take to print, and I found this extremely helpful. It'll also pop up with any warnings of, like, if you're low on filament or if it paused for some reason, something's clogged. It's going to let you know all of this here. Now with printing, I have only used the official Elegoo PLA filament that was provided to do my test. So I can't give feedback on using the different filaments for this specific printer, but what I have printed, which has been close to 100 individual parts now in the last month and a half, all have worked out great. The support structures have all come off pretty easily, which I've actually found I like the tree support better, as it is just easier to come off in general. As well as for the build volume of this printer, the width, depth, and height are all 256 millimeters. I will note though, I did have one issue, which may still be user issue, but I've had the same issue 3 times now with replacing the filament. And that is, the printer does tell you when you are running out of filament and to replace it. And I've always caught it when the filament is already done, the print has stopped. And I've gone through the steps of replacing the filament, inserting the filament into the tube all the way. It goes through all the checklists, and then it starts printing, and it prints for about 2 seconds, which I guess it is printing the extra filament. And then it'll just run, not printing anything, because for some reason it will not pick up the filament again without keeping pushing it in until it finally catches while printing. And I really think this is user error. I just haven't figured it out yet properly, but that's the only downfall that I have found with this printer so far. But overall, my experience is that this is a great printer, especially for the price. Printing really tall spike pieces, I actually ended up cutting off the spikes because they were too pointy. Just because of past printers, I was used to the top points always becoming mushy, and I was really surprised by this. All of the cleanup for any type of stair stepping has been very minimal, as well as I've used this now to basically complete my Magic cosplay from Marvel Rivals, as well as I've started working for more engineering projects such as wing harnesses for future projects. But overall, I do recommend this printer. I think it is great, especially if it's your first time getting a printer. It's fully enclosed, so it'll keep all of the critter hair away, it'll keep all of the smell in there, and it's pretty user-friendly, especially with all of the Elegoo interface of doing it on your computer and being Wi-Fi, as well as having the camera at your disposal and even recording it. So yeah, that is my thoughts on the Elegoo Centauri Carbon. Highly recommend it. Let me know in the comments if this is a printer you are interested in, or if maybe there's something that I missed. Let me know in the comments for other people to be aware of, as well as like the video and subscribe to the channel. Would love to have you as part of our community, and I'll see you for our next one.